We now return to open session at 8:01.
Make a motion to return.
I have a motion by Councilman Silva. Do I have a second to return from executive session?
I'll second.
Seconded by Councilman Nissen. All those in favor? 4-0. Thank you. Okay, this is our review, our city manager's yearly review. I know that you gave us some documentation.
In fact, if I may make the announcement of the average score, council, the average score of the city council for the city manager is like 3.355 for this evaluation period.
Okay. At this time, do you have any comments, Henrietta, or I'll take some comments by the council?
The only comments I have, Mayor, thank you for the floor, is actually the packet that I passed out to you, or just highlighting some of the projects that we're going through this year. You've seen some of these before. I just want to remind you, this is going to be my focus as we're coming up in this new fiscal year. That's the end. If you have any questions or comments, you come see me, or I'll answer any that you have today. Do you need a copy, Mayor?
I'm sorry, I don't know where it is. Thank you. Okay, at this time, council, here's your, I will give you an opportunity to speak to Mr. Turner or go over some of the numbers that were given.
I'll go first.
Okay, Councilman Nissen.
Okay, objectives and goals. I think with what you have done with the USA Sewer, USDA Sewer, USDA Water, your block grant, City Hall ADA, and 2,000 tax notes, all of them are on time. And I think with the amount of work you did, you've done me an exceptional job on that.
I will go ahead and read my review. The evaluator's suggestions for improvement and other comments. I do not feel that Mrs. Turner leads our city fairly and to the best of her ability. When you have 2 years in a row of such bad audits, I believe that she could have been desperately trying to find ways to correct these issues and informing the council of such problems if needed at every meeting if needed. Together, the council and Mrs. Turner should have been working together for solutions on this. Any other comments by the council?
I can read my evaluation summary.
Okay.
This is basically everything. You can read my review. Everything is okay. The review problems I see with the city. With HR, that we need to have records for hiring for equal opportunity. We may do a matrix on that, so that will be, I think, addressed. I think the community development needs work with code compliant follow-ups, and I think we need a lot better phone answering system and return call system than what we have, because I get a lot of calls that saying we call down there, nobody gives us an answer. Then I hear that they call and talk to somebody, but yet that person will not return a call back. So we got to come up with a development on calling them back, fixing the problem. You have three or four people up in that front office, so somebody can get a call log and make sure it gets back. That's the only way. Get some type of SOP on the phone system.
Any other comments by the council for Mrs. Turner?
I guess my concern was touched on by both comments already made before me, and that relates to personnel management. I've been fortunate enough to have several city employees approach me directly, as well as indirectly, with concerns of how their management is running, being run, whether it be their direct supervisor or the supervisors above them. And these concerns coming in from employees are very consistent, regardless of department. And that's what concerns me, is that it is far-reaching, and that it's not only limited to City Hall employees, but it goes beyond that out to the field. I believe workers or municipalities, any government worker really, goes into the field with the expectation of doing some good for the community that they work in, and the greater good. and understanding that their pay might not be up to par in government work as to where it might be in private sector. So with that in mind, I would hope that they would have a great, prosperous environment to work in, and that they feel that they have a boundless opportunity to advance at their will, whether it be laterally or horizontally. So what I'm hearing is that's not true here, unfortunately. And that's a really big concern of mine, because I believe that City of Floresville deserves employees who will greet them with a smile, who won't hang up on them, get frustrated with them, will have calls returned. These are all, again, consistent complaints that I've received from various departments throughout the city. And that's, to me, it's really tough, because I believe that a great work environment starts from the top. And in this particular case, that falls on city manager.
Any other comments?
My biggest concern is, again, a lot of the projects, waterline project coming out to this place, the fiasco, and how much money it costs the city. You should have known that TxDOT hadn't approved, engineering, that M&S engineering did. You didn't bring that to the council to say, hey, don't vote on this, because it can cause us huge problems later. So that was about $150,000, loss that the city had. I think you dropped the ball on that. You know, a lot of the equipment by our maintainer bought for the city, the price on it was way too high. Can't even get the money back. And plus, it was not a piece of equipment the city needed. It was way too large. I don't know where you got your numbers or who you talked to buy this equipment. That was about another $40,000 mistake you made on it. But I'm just really disappointed in several things like that you've done. That I feel the responsibility fell on you on this. And that's, some of my main concerns have happened. The cost is great. I feel there should be a lot more improvement on that, but mistakes were made. It's cost us a lot more.
Any response, Mr. Chairman?
Yeah.
Okay, if there are any other comments by the council?
Yeah, me.
Okay.
I think you need to communicate more with the employees and the council. Answer your phone, return your calls to the council or the employees. You need to ride around, look at our roads, our water systems, all our infrastructure. Make sure that everything's going the way it's supposed to be. And I don't feel that you do that, because if you did, you'd probably be wanting new shocks on your cars and stuff, And when we ask you a question, I think you need to have better knowledge on how much monies we have available. You're quick to say, hey, yeah, we have money for this, we have money for that, and here we are in a deficit. We're spending money like crazy. We're not prioritizing on what needs to be done. You're not letting our road guys be road guys, or the water people be water people. You've got them picking up brush, doing different things that they shouldn't be doing. We bought all this new equipment, and we have all the equipment to do everything, and now our doors closed, our windows closing, because hey, we're coming into wintertime, and we're not going to be able to do as much as we really need to do. And you got to make sure that that your director's doing his job, and you allow him to do his job. We really haven't done anything. When I first came on the council, you told us that all our machines were broke and everything else. They were red tagged and everything, and that was not so. We hadn't worked roads for 4 years. We just now started doing potholes, and they're already stopped. We're not doing anything right now. We have several complaints on different areas in the city hall. I mean, and you know the complaints, and you're not doing anything about it.
I don't know the complaints, but I look forward to hearing from them from you.
Well, just like for me, like getting my permits, you know, there's people wanting to get their permits. This lady, we just passed her thing to get approved. She's been trying to get it approved for a year and a half. You know, that's nonsense, you know. If whoever's doing that job needs to be doing it the proper way. And if she doesn't know how to do it, get her some assistance or do something, because nobody deserves to be treated that way. I didn't like it, and I hope that you do something about it. You know, it's going on 2 years. That's the reason I ran for council. I said I didn't want nobody going through the same
things that I went through. I'll give you about 30 more seconds.
Okay, well, that's fine.
Okay. Any other comments?
Yeah, my comment is there has been a lot of stuff done on the streets. And yes, I know for a fact a bunch of the equipment has been broke down because of neglect and because of lack of money from the previous council. Never got money together. And yes, we are spending less money this year, and we're going to be closest to zero budget than they have in the past 3 years. So that's just in your numbers, that's just in your books. And you can talk to Public Works man about the streets they have done. And yes, we've had some scattered rain. And yes, that's some slowed down. But I think our public works street people, you don't think they're doing the streets. I think they're doing the streets, and I think they're doing one heck of a good job.
That's not what I'm saying. I'm saying that they're taking a brush instead of doing roads. That's what I'm saying.
Okay, I will let the council have one more comment. If anybody has one more comment for regarding Mrs. Turner's yearly review.
I've got one last one. I think we need to prioritize on your budget to make sure that we're able to do the things that we need to do. The infrastructure, to me, is the most important of all the city. So,
there's where I stand. Councilman Jimenez, Councilman Nissen.
Wasn't the last agenda in the Public Works Director come in with a priority list?
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. Okay, thank you.
The one that received halfway through the year.
Right. So we just got one last time. Priority list last meeting.
Any other comments by the council?
Got one. Just I saw earlier this year where you took everybody off the street for 2 weeks to clean the parking lot here. Community center. That, you know, during the summer before the July 4th fest, those workers would have been a lot better use fixing potholes and doing street repair. Now that you've swept up all the gravel off the parking lot out here, dirt, now you can watch it fall apart a lot faster. And I don't know why you spend so much time, so many hours of city workers, you know, maintaining our streets, to, you know, putting parking lot ahead of, you know, drainage and everything else. You know, I think that was poorly time managed, you know, on your account.
Okay, council, I think we've gone over this review. I will entertain any citizens' comments before any possible action taken. Okay. Moving on, at this moment on executive session 4B, we have returned from executive session, and I will entertain a motion to take any action or to take no action regarding this review.
I'd like to make a motion that we recommend Mrs. Turner to give a standard 2% raise.
I have a motion on the floor by Councilman Nissen. Do I have a second? I have no second on that. Do I have any other motion by the council?
I would recommend talking to your new attorneys about that if you want.
So make a motion on accepting the yearly review that we've done.
Okay. I have a motion on the floor to accept the yearly review on Mrs. Turner. Do I have a second?
Second.
I have a second by Councilman Silva. All those in favor, please raise your right hand. 4-0. Thank you. With no further action on our agenda tonight, this meeting is now adjourned at 8:17.
Oh, you got it.